ದೃಷ್ಟಸ್ತು ನಿತ್ಯಾದೃಷ್ಟಿ, ದೃಷ್ಟಸ್ತು ನಿತ್ಯಾದೃಷ್ಟಿ. ಬಟ್ ದ ವಿಜನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೀರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಇಟರ್ನಲ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಶ್ರುತೀಸ್. ನಹಿ ದೃಷ್ಟರ್ ದೃಷ್ಟಿರ್ಲೋಪ ವಿದ್ಯತೆ. ದ ವಿಜನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೀರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ನೆವರ್ ಬಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್. 4.3.23 ಅನುಮಾನಚ್ಚ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಇವನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲುಯೆನ್ಸ್. ಹನುಮಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಭಾಷ್ಯಂ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಂದಿರ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ವಿಮದಾಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾಂ ಅವ್ಯವಿಚಾರಿತ್ವಾತ್ ಪರೇಷ್ಟ ಆತ್ವಿತಿ ಪ್ರಯೋಗೋತ್ಪತ್ತೇರಿತ್ಯರ್ಥ. ವಿಮತಾಂ ದೃಷ್ಟೌ ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ನಿತ್ಯಾಂ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟರ್ನಲ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅವ್ಯವಿಚಾರಿತ್ವಾತ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನೆವರ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೀಸ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಪರೇಷ್ಟ ಆತ್ವತ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅವರ್ ಆಪರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆತ್ಮ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫೀಸ್. ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫೀಸ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟರ್ನಲ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಲ್ಲಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟರ್ನಲ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೀರ್ ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟರ್ನಲ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ದೇ ಗಿವ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆಸ್ ಅವ್ಯವಿಚಾರಿತ್ವಾತ್ ಸೇಮ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು. ಅಂಧಸ್ಯಾಪಿ ಘಟಾದ್ಯಾಭಾಸ ವಿಷಯ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ಉಪಲಭ್ಯತೆ. ಯುಕ್ತಿ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಂಗ್ ಗಿವನ್ ನಾವ್ ಲಾಜಿಕ್ ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಸೈಟ್ ದ ವಿಜನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೀರ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟರ್ನಲ್. ಇಸ್ ಈವನ್ ಎ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಅಂಧಸ್ಯ ಘಟಾದಿ ಆಭಾಸ ವಿಷಯ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ಉಪಲಭ್ಯತೆ. ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ವಿಜನ್ ಇನ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ and is able to see such jar etc. things which are actually what? Superimposed in the dream, because nothing is real there. A superimposed jar is being seen by him, even by a blind person, by what thing is seen there, what is the source or the instrument of seeing the thing, because he is blind by birth. And even in the dream state, his external chakshu also, even if we have, it will not work. Just like us. And he is blind anyway. Therefore, he does not have, he has experience also of a jar even in his waking state. Then how he could see a jar in the dream? Depending upon the past impressions.
By touching. By touching and feeling and the healing.
But he is seeing here. The knowledge that he is attaining in the dream. That's what I'm saying. How you could see? But still you have your eyes in the sleep is not. Another eyes is there.
That's how he also has.
From where it came, that's what is the question. With what eyes he is seeing over there? Even if he sees himself as a blind in the sleep, in the dream also, then? Still he is having a vision of the jar. He is experiencing jar and everything. And that vision is of the seer, not of the blind person, not this sight. Is andasyapi ghatatya bhasa vishaya swapne drishti upalabhyate. For even a blind person has vision in dreams and is able to see a pot etc. To experience the pot etc. which is just an impression actually, not in reality, just a vasana. This is just ghatali abhasa vishaya, bhasya abhasa. It's an impression. It's not in reality, it's not there in any way. But still he experiences, he upalabhyate. And therefore you have to say that drishti, that sight, that vision through which a blind person experiences in the dream, that vision itself is the vision of the seer, that's eternal. Satari, itara drishti nashe, na nashati. That means with the logic by what we are going to say here, even this external vision may get lost, it may get destroyed, but that vision will never get. Satari itara drishti nashe na nashati. Sa means the vision of the seer. That nitya drishti, sa nitya drishti. This anitya drishti nashepi, itara drishti means anitya drishti nashepi na nashati. Therefore in dream, the vision of the seer is not getting lost or destroyed or distorted in any way with the loss of the other vision which the blind person is in the waking state. Sa drishtur drishti That vision itself we call as the drishti, the vision of the seed. Taya, avapariplutaya, nitya drishtya. Taya, avipariplutaya, nitya drishtya. Through that unfailing eternal vision. Avipariplutaya means unfailing. Nitya, eternal, drishtya. Through that eternal and unfailing vision. Why it is eternal and unfailing? Because swarupa bhutaya is the nature of the self only. There is nothing there. There also you can't consider I and it's my vision. As we see in the waking state, we are two. I and my vision. Don't consider like that seed and its vision. No, the seed is itself the vision is itself the seed. The swarupa bhutaya, being identical totally with the swarupam, with the nature, with the self only, with the supreme self. That is why the swayam jyoti samakhyaya itaram anityam drishtim swapna buddhantayor vasana pratyarupam nityam eva pashyan drishtir drishta bhavati iti vyapadishati. It is swarupa bhutaya. Therefore, it is called as it is identical with the Supreme Self. It is called by the word Swayam Jyotihi Samakhyaya, by the name Self Effulgent Light. Therefore, the seer sees always. Nityam Eva Pashyam. Nityam Eva Pashyam. He is continuously, regularly, always seeing what? This Itaram Anityam Drishtim. This, the other one, the other, what is the other one? The transitory sight, which is being experienced in both states, swapna buddhantayoha, in the dream and the waking state. Buddhant is waking. In dream state, how it is seeing the sight? Vasana rupam, and the waking state as pratyarupam, as an impression in the dream state and as a perception in the waking state respectively. Nityam eva pashyam, seeing continuously all the time without fail. That is why we say that vision, which is Swayam Jyoti, Sarvabhuta Jyoti, is Drishtir Drishta. That is being stated by us by the statement Drishtir Drishta, Shrute Shrota, Mater Manta, Vigyatir Vigyata. These words are used by us only in this sense, not with the sense of any difference in them. This is a Devadatta se Drishti. Kshina bhavati. Here what is there? The person is different and his drishti is different. That's transitory. It has reduced. The sight has gone down. We are saying this statement. It is not like this here. Drishti is drishti. Shashtiyan is prathama. But here it is shashtiyan prathama. Shakansara as raho shira yivat. Abhede only. Shashti it is. Abhede sambunde shashti. Natu bhede. That is why he says all these explanations so much. All the time, nityameva pashyanapi, drishtir drashta bhavati. Evancha sati, drishtireva surupam asya. You see? Evancha sati, when such being the case, drishtireva, the vision is what? Is itself surupam asya. The vision is itself, its nature, the nature of the Supreme Self is what? Vision only. There is the Supreme Self and vision are not two different entities. Because the Supreme Self is what? Svaprakasha. That Svaprakasha is stated by Drishti. Nitya Drishti. Nitya Digrupam. Adhyaropita Anit Drishtyadi Varjitam. You see? It's very clear. It is the eternal vision. Nitya Digrupam. And how it is further? It is devoid of all the superimposed transitory sight, etc. Adhyaropita anitya drishti adi varjitam. Drishti adi means drishti, shruti, mati, vigyati, all those what? Anitya. Anitya, all these things does not exist on because all the superpositions. Adhyaropita varjitam. It is devoid of all such superpositions like drishti, etc. That is here drishti means anitya drishti, anitya shruti, all those things. Where drishti Kanadadinam iva evanchasito. I left one line. There's something where it's gone. Sarupam asya agni aushnivat. Oh, this sentence left over. Agni aushnivat. It is just like the heat of fire. They are not two different entities. It is just like heat of fire that you can see the drishti is of the Supreme Self. It is the nature itself of the Supreme Self, the vision. And we cannot consider here just like kanadadinamiva, no. Kanadadinam, kanadadinamiva, drishti vitrikta, anyaschetano drashta. And there is no other chetana, conscious, drashta, seer, being stated as atma, by the word atma, by those people which is different from the drishti, from the vision. By whom? By Vaisheshika Siddhantas, Kanada Maharshi, etc. Conscious, or some people say, Kanadadi, he said, if you say atma is jada in Gautama, Nayayikas, they were unconscious. Chetano, achetano va drashta. Chetana drashta in Kanada, achetana drashta in Gautama, Nyaya, and Vaisheshika. Conscious or unconscious, see, over and all, this eternal vision, separate from this, different from this, as stated by Vaisheshikas Kanada, and Nayayikas Gautama, etc., and their school of philosophy, that cannot be accepted over here. We don't accept it. As they maintain their philosophy, that cannot be accepted by according to the Shruti. Now you come to this road, which was taken before. In between, tad brahma ahatmanam eva nitya digrupam adhyaropita anitya drishtyadi varjitam eva avet viditavat. Tat ahatmanam eva avet. We are going to explain this mantra. Tat means brahma, that supreme self. Avet means viditavat, new. What? Ahatmanam eva, only itself. What is this atma? Nitya Digrupam. Nitya Digrupam, the eternal vision. Why you are saying it is eternal vision? Because it is devoid of adhyaropita, devoid of all the superimpositions which are transitory drishti, transitory shruti, etc. Transitory vision, etc. Anitya drishtiyadi varjitam. Eva. Only that avet viditavat, that Brahman knew. The Purupakshi says here the objection now. Nanu viprati siddham vidham. This is totally contradictory, self-contradictory statement. How can the Shruti say so? It knew itself. Because in future, in the later portion of the Upanishad, you are going to totally negate this. And you say, one should not try to know the knower. And here the knower is knowing himself, you are telling. How is it possible? Na vijyataram, vijyatir vijyataram vijaniyaha. For the Upanishad text says very clearly, one should not even try to know the knower. Vijyate vijyataram, the knower, we try to know the knower of the knowledge. Iti shrudehe vijyatar vijyanam. Iti shrudehe vijyatar vijyanam, yaduktam tat pratishittam. Therefore, what you are saying now, Vijyato Vijyanam, Vijyata had knowledge of himself. This is totally contradictory. 3, 4, 2. Does knowing the knower means it's self-contradictory? Shroto, Shri Shrote, Vijyatur Vijyanam, Vipratishiddham. That's how you have to take. Conjugate with the previous word. Therefore, Vijyatur Vijyanam, Vipratishiddham Bhavati. Therefore, to know the knower, mean, knowing the knower means itself contradictory. It's yet no, not so. Why? Evam vijnanat na vipratishetha. This way of knowledge, the sort of knowledge, the type of knowledge that's being attained is by the Brahman shows that there is no contradiction at all. How? It's very clear. You said he knew himself and said the knower should not know himself. Just opposite it is. Then no. Evam drishter drashtaiti vijyayati eva. Atmanam eva ved means what he knew actually is drishter drashta. Iti vijyayati eva. This type of knowledge, the sort of knowledge that is attained is not contradictory, because the knowledge that he attained is what? Drishter drashta. He does not say, I am the knower, I knew myself. This is not the meaning over here. I being the knower, knew myself. This is not the meaning of the statement. The meaning of the statement is drishter drashta. This is what he knew. Evam drishter drashta iti vidyayate eva. As a witness, it is known as seer of sight. That means to say, as a witness only, he came to know that the seer of the sight, the vision of the seer, was known as what? As a witness. That is the meaning of drishta drashta and atmaneva ved. He knew the vision of the sight as witness of everything. Therefore, he became everything. When he became the witness of everything, he knows everything, then he became everything to state it like that. Tasma sarvam abhavat. Further explanation is that anijnana anapekshatvaccha. The reason is, to know the witness, he did not take the assistance of any other knowledge. Anijnana anapekshatvaccha. Also, it does not depend on any other knowledge to know the witness. You are the witness of everything that you know. For this, you need to know this, you need not be depending on some other knowledge. It is Svata Pramana, self-evident. Therefore, Nacha Drashtur Nityam Drishtim Ityam Vidyate Drashtri Vishayam Drishtim Anyam Akanchade. Because he who knows that the vision of the seer is eternal, does not wish to see anything else other than himself. It in any other way also. Drashto nityeva drishti ityam vigyate. Once a person knows that the vision of the seer is eternal, to know so, he is not depending upon any other source, any other instrument of knowledge. Drashtri vishayam drishtim Anyam nacha akanshate. In any, he does not wish also to see or to know this by any other way. But instead, what happens? Once you know this, all other means get seized automatically. Nivartatehi drishti vishe drishti akanksha tada sambhavadeva. But instead, what's going to happen is, the wish, if it would have been before, I want to see the seer and his vision. If there would be a wish in somebody, that wish also gets ceases once he knows that it is the witness itself. The vision of the seer is nothing other than the witness, and that is I myself. When he knows so, then the wish to know or to perceive the seer and its vision ceases totally. Nivartate hi drishti vishaya drishti akanksha. Why? That the sambhavadeva. It is impossible to know as an object. A self-evident thing cannot be tried to be perceived as an object. Therefore, you can't try to find the witness somewhere as an object. Where you can find it? When you say this, it means the witness. And that witness, once you know that I am the witness, all the wish to know the seer or the vision of the seer ceases, because it's impossible to know it as an object. Tad asambhava deva. It's just like a wish ceases when you come to know that the thing does not exist at all. You are trying to know a vandhya putra, a barren woman's son. And once you know that, a barren woman cannot have a son at all, then your wish automatically ceases to know it, to find it. Nahi avidyamane vishaye akanchasya. It's just like this, he says. Nahi avidyamane vishaye akanksha kasachid upajayate. Just like nobody hankers after a thing that does not exist at all. Similarly, it is over here. It does not exist like an object. Then how you can know it? If it would have been an object, we would wish to know it, and we could know it through some means also. But as it is not an object at all, it is impossible to know it through any means. Therefore, it is just like a thing which is non-existent. The only difference is, it is absolute existence. And what is the illustration given is? About a non-existent. Just like the hankering ceases regarding a non-existent thing. When you come to know this thing which I am searching around is non-existent, your wish ceases. Similarly, about this also he says, but the opposite, just the thing is opposite or here. It's absolute existence and it's self-evident. Therefore also the wish ceases. Therefore any desire stops or ceases when you really know about that thing. Either it is non-existent or it is self-evident. In both the cases, the desire ceases. Nacha drishya drishtihi drittara vishayi kartum utsahade. Further explains, you see. Drishya drishti means you have this sight, this vision. Drishya, which is an object. The sight, which is an object of witness. This sight, and that sight which is itself an object of witness, of eternal vision, that cannot dare to visualize the vision of the seer, the eternal vision. Vishayi kartum na utsahate. It cannot make it an object and try to perceive it. Yataha tam akankshita, depending upon which it would ever desire to know it also. Therefore, it can never desire also to grasp it. Nacha surva vishayakancha swasevasya. And if we say, let Brahma itself think, wish to know itself, then no, it's not like that also. Nor does anybody to wish to see himself, to know himself also. Because, therefore what happens is tasmat. What is the meaning of, then what is going to happen over here by knowing? Tada, what is the result of this then? He says, tasmat only adhyaropa nivritti is the result. Ajnana adhyaropa nivritti reva atmana vedityuktam na atmana vishayi karanam. You are not making this self an object of your knowledge by saying atmanam avet. Because atma is dvitya. Dvitya means it shows the object. Ghatam avet. Yatha atmana avet. Don't consider like that over here. Here the dvitya, the second case that has come, does not mean, the accusative case that is over here, does not mean object. But it means what? It is meaning only this much. It knew itself alone. This passage means over here that the person who knew himself, what is going to happen with him? The cessation of the superimposition along with its cause, the ignorance takes place. This is the meaning of Atmanivavet. And not actually cognizing the self over here is being meant by the passage Atmanivavet. Because nobody can cognize or make the self an object of his knowledge by any means of knowledge. Na Atmano Vishayikaranam. Then Purpakshi says, the objector, how can that such a self be ever? Is there any such thing also which is self-evident, self-luminous, self-effulgent, etc., etc., what you said just now? I don't think that there is any such thing in this world. So how can self be? He asks. Tat katam avet itya. How did it know such a thing? Aham brahmasmi. This is the form of knowledge that it knew. Aham brahmasmi. Aham drishtehe drashta atma. What is that aham? You have to take it, aham means not the individual self. Drishter drashta atma. The witness. The witness knew itself as what? The Supreme Self. I am the unlimited, undifferentiated, the non-dual Brahman. The witness realized this. Bhavamiti. I means the self, Atma, that is the seer of the sight, the seer of the vision, knew itself as what? I am the Supreme Self. This is what it knew. Brahmaiti, by the word Brahma in this particular passage, what do you mean? He says, yes, Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma. It is that Supreme Self which has been mentioned in these passages, which is immediate and direct. Sarvantara Atma, the Self that is within one and all. Ashanadyatita, that which is beyond hunger, thirst, etc. Neti, neti. That which is stated by, described as, not this, not this. And astulam ananu ityammadi laksham. And also characterized as neither gross nor subtle, etc., etc. That which is being pointed out by these passages should be, is referred by the word Brahman in the present passage. Tadeva aham asmi. That I am certainly. Eva, certainly, that only I am. Nanya sansari. And I am not the other, the transitory self. Yatha bhavan ah. Just as you stated, my teacher, that I will experience now. Yatha bhavan ah. As and according to your instructions, I have experienced it now, that I am Brahman myself. Tasmat, this is a mantra. Tasmat, tat saram abhavat. Tasmat, therefore, evam vijnana. Tasmat means, evam vijnanat. By knowing thus, what happened? Tat, that Supreme Self, it, the Supreme Self, became all saram abhavat. It became all. It became all means what? One who knows Brahman, what he becomes? Brahmvit, Brahma eva bhavati. Every sarvam means Brahma, pariyayavachi. Don't think this dual word is not called by the word sarvam. Sarvam is Brahma. Tasmat, Brahma vijyanat, kim bhavati? Brahma eva bhavati. Because in all other mantras said, Brahma eva bhavati, abhayam vai bhavati. Every sarvam bhavati is sarvam jagat bhavati. Not like that. Sarvam is sarvam Brahma. And sarva and Brahma pariyavachi, according to Yukta also. You can go through the tippans, a lot of discussions in the tippana. And by this, according to Anvigri also, because Brahman itself had entered all the adjuncts, and it knew itself means what? It became Brahman, means all the adjuncts got disappeared. Ek jivvad has been established over here. Anvigri's last statement, in his last sentence you see, Brahmaiva avidyaya sansarati. Vidya cha muchyate. That means ek jivvada. Brahma itself goes through transmigration due to ignorance. It experiences transmigration due to ignorance and itself gets liberated through knowledge. Because none other than Brahman is being bound or liberated. There none other Brahman, there is anything called as jiva. If one Brahman is one, or jiva is one, there is not be many jivas at all. Ek Jivada established. This is Mukhya Vedanta. Main Vedanta is, what is the main dicta of Vedanta is Ek Jivada. Anek Jivada is only to secondary, to make people understand certain things. To make them introduced into Vedanta. Yeah, okay, tummar dimag mein hai Anek Jiva. I am different, that Jiva is different. Let us say, okay, let it be so. For the time being. He said in the last number tippana also, Brahmavaidam ityanaya shrutya, sarvatra ekayo jiva vekshati iti ek jiva vatasiva shrautattvam suchyat aha brahmaiva ityadi. In the special 6 number tippana, Lord discussed about this, sa brahma and saram priyavachi. Given all the mantras and all the texts here and there. And especially, one rule he has given, the third line of the tippana, bhinna pravritti nimittanam shabdanam aikartyam samanadikarnim iti nyayena. There is a logic, a rule in Vyakaran, in the grammar. Bhinna pravritti nimittanam. The words, the meaning of which, the being used, those words used, the terms used, the usage of them have got caused different causes. The usage of any term depends on cause. On jati, dravya, guna, kriya, etc. The nimitta is different of each and every word. The cause of terminology is different to each and every one. But when such terms are used together in coordination, they mean one single thing. Then, giving up their different meanings, they both together give one meaning. जिस रूल इन व्याकरण है देख रहा भिन्न प्रवृत्ति निमित्तानाम शब्दानाम टर्म्स विचार इन यूसेज ड्यू टू द डिफरेंट डिफरेंट कॉजेस बट व्हेन यूज टुगेदर सामनाज बिटवीन कोऑर्डिनेशन देन ऐकार्थ्यम स्यात् दे विल बी गिविंग वन पर्टिकुलर मीनिंग ओनली नॉट अ विशिष्ट क्वालिफाइड मीनिंग इति न्यायेन एंड हियर व्हाट आर डूइंग अहम ब्रह्मास्मि तत् सर्वम अभवत् आदि सामनाधिकरण्य अहम एंड ब्रह्म दोनों प्रथमांत इज नॉट नॉमिनेटिव केस तत् ब्रह्म सर्वम अभवत् तस्मात् तत् सर्वम अभवत् तत् इस प्रथमांतम सर्वम इस प्रथमांतम नपुंसक युग सर्वम सर्वे सर्वाणि कोऑर्डिनेशन स्प्रिट सामनाधिकरण्य देयर दिस मीन वन मीनिंग ओनली There cannot be two different meanings. You cannot say that Brahman became all this world and Brahman and world are different. That two different meanings you are taking. That cannot be possible. And Sarvam means Brahma only. Brahma became Brahman back. Due to ignorance, it was non-Brahman and non-Sarvam and now it has become Brahman and Sarvam. That's all the meaning of this. A Brahma dhyaropan apagama tat karyasya sarvatkvasya divrutya sarvavadhiti chatte. Therefore, what is being stated over here is, because of the cessation of the superimposition a brahma adhyaropana apagama because of the cessation of the superimposition superimposed notion that I am not the supreme self this was the a brahma I am not the supreme self this was the superimposition and that has been now removed apagama so tat karya sucha asarvatvase nivritya and the karya of a brahma is what Asarvattam, as and because I am not Brahma, I am not Sarvam also. And its effect, the notion of not being all, both of them ceases. That is also gone. Nivritya, therefore it is said over here now, Sarvat, it became all. Tasmad, yuktam meva manushyamanyante yad brahmidya sarvam avishyamaiti. Hence, these men are justified. In their thinking that through the knowledge of the Supreme Self, they would become all, they would become Brahman. What they have, their thinking is, that is right, that is justified now. This was in, I think, 149. Manusha manyante. Isn't it? This mantra was there in 149. Yad manusha manyante brahmidya sarvam bhavishyama. Yad prishtham. Now it gives The answer has been given to the question that was been asked. What did you know? Kimutar Brahma Ved iti yat prishtam yasmat tasrambhavad iti tan nirnitam. The question that was asked, what did that Supreme Self knew by which it became all? This has been now answered by the following passage. By 1410. 1410, up to this year already, straight the Bhashyam is over. Brahma vai dhamma grasit, tadatmana yaved, aham brahmasmiti, tasma sarvavaditi. This much is the answer, the reply given to the question. Kim tadave, kim tadave. Yes, matat sarvavavad. Now is further mantra, tat, means tatra, yo yo devana madhya pratibuddhata, pratibuddhavan, आत्मान विदक्तेन विदिना स एव प्रतिबुद्धात्मा तत् ब्रह्म भवत् तथा ऋषिणां तथा मनुष्याणां च मध्ये तत् इस मंत्र मीन्स तत्र विद रिगार्ड टू दैट यो यो देवानां मंत्र मध्ये इस भाषण अमंग द गॉड्स हूएवर प्रतिबुद्धत न्यू इट प्रतिबुद्धत इस मंत्र एक्सप्लेनेशन Pratibuddhavan Atmanam Yathoktin Vidina. This is the expression. Knew it means the Supreme Self in the manner as described just above. Sa Eva is Upanishad mantra. Sa Eva, he, that person, that devata, that deity, certainly. What happened? Pratibuddhatma. That person certainly having realized this self. This explanation. Sa Eva. That's the explanation. Pratibuddhatma sa devata. Sa devata who realized the self properly, what did he become? He also became Tat. Tat means Brahma. He also became that, means the Supreme Self, Abhavat, means became. Tatha, similarly, among the sages, Rishinam, Tatha Manushyanancha Madhya, and so also among, same among the men too. तथा मनुष्यान तथा ऋषिणाम अभवत इस मंत्र तथा ऋषिणाम तथा मनुष्यानाम इस मंत्र मंत्र मध्य इस व्याख्या भाष्य ना फर्दर ओनली भाष्य देवानाम इत्यादि लोक दृष्टि अपेक्षा न ब्रह्म तो बुद्धि उच्यते हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल टू से दिस नाउ वंस दैट ब्रह्मन बिकेम ब्रह्मन आफ्टर दैट देयर इज नो ड्युअलिटी एट ऑल फ्रॉम वेयर दिस पीपल केम सडनली दिस देवता ऋषि एंड मनुष्य The Bhashyakara has explained that is why don't be worried about this. Huh? This is all Prag Prabodha and Loka Drishtya. Two reasons. Prag Prabodha, what he had seen as Devata, etc., even among them, anybody can become Brahman. Or Loka Drishtya. Loka Drishtya Pechya. Devanam Ityadi, the statement, the passage over here, that's mentioned Devanam, etc., etc., the deities, etc., the words. Gods, sages, men, etc., which is being stated over in the mantra, are used from the conventional point of view of an ignorant general person, common man, layman. Loka drishti apeksha. Na brahmat buddhya uchate. Na brahmat buddhya uchate. This has not been stated from that of the vision of the Supreme Self, from the point of view. Or the vision of the Supreme Self, but not that point of view. On what basis you are all saying so? Because pura purusha avshiti sarvatra brahmayvanu pravishtam ityavachama. For we have already said that it is the Supreme Self which is entered everywhere into all the things. As put forth in the passage, that pura purusha avshiti iti. That Supreme Self entered first into these bodies. 2518. This mantra will be coming later, but we have already discussed about this mantra previously only before. There Bhashyakara is Avochama, not Vakshati. When the mantra will be Vakshati, but the meaning has been already discussed before, they have said Avochama. You are studying 1410. The mantra is 2518. It's going to come later, after a long time. But it is avachana. Because we already stated, depending when we are discussing 147, Sayeshaya Pravishta. Sayeshaya Pravishta, this mantra was in 147. There only we had discussed about 2518 also. And we have stated very clearly that Brahman itself as the first person who entered into this body was Brahman. Then all these deities also start to come and sit inside this in different places. Ataha. शरीरादि उपाधि जनित लोक दृष्टि अपेक्षया देवानाम इत्यादि उच्यते हेंस द वर्ड्स गॉड्स एक्सेट्रा आर बी स्टेटेड ओवर हियर फ्रॉम द लोक दृष्टि अपेक्षया फ्रॉम द कन्वेंशनल स्टैंड पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू डिटरमिन्ड बाय होम बाय द लिमिटिंग एडजेंट्स उपाधि जनित विच आर डिटरमिन्ड बाय द लिमिटिंग एडजेंट्स सच एज शरीरादि बॉडी एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा परमार्थतस्तो तत्र तत्र ब्रह्मैव अग्रासीत् बट इन रियलिटी इफ यू वांट टू से देन वी हैव टू से दैट इट वाज द सुप्रीम सेल्फ ओनली विद इन द गॉड्स विद इन द मैन एवरीवेयर इन ईच एंड एवरी सुप्रीम पोजीशन वी कैन सी व्हाट इट इज इन ईच एंड एवरी पिक्चर वी सी द क्लॉक सिमिलरली हियर आल्सो इन ईच एंड एवरी सुप्रीम पोजीशन व्हाट इज देयर लाइंग बिहाइंड इज द सेल्फ ओनली द सुप्रीम सेल्फ Therefore, in each and every supreme, whether it is God or men or sages or whatever it is, in everything is Brahma only. Paramarthasto tatra tatra, in all such adjuncts, Brahmaiva agrasit. Agra means what? Prag pratibodhat. The Supreme Self, which was in those divine and all other parts. Tatra tatra, Bhaskara takes two times. Tatra means gods, devanam. And again, tatra means rishinam, manushanamcha. Divine bodies and all other bodies, even before realization, prak pratibodha, even before realization, Devadi Sarvesha, in all the bodies of gods, etc., it was Brahma only, the Supreme Self only, that was existing. Anyathaiva vibhavyamanam. Anyathaiva vibhavyamanam. Being looked upon but like something else. Anyatha eva. Even though Brahman was there, but still it was looked upon as something else, as a different thing. It was differentiated, variegation was there. Tad atanivavet tathaiva cha sarvam abhavat. It knew itself alone and thereby it became all. In the similar way here also.